5 years I've been living a dream. Close my eyes, see the grapefruit sit in the trees. Scent of blossom as it mix in the breeze. But when I think about it now, how different it be. But the pain could never change my love for the valley. The same place we've been staying when we come with the family. It's got a comfort surrounding. It's truly something. I'm standing down to the medical team that helped us when we were down. We will never forget the first seizure we saw. The form in my seeping as it leaked from his jaw. I never prayed before, but now I'm speaking to God. Like we can't do this alone, please. We need you in charge. Time stopped while we waited for the paramedics. Daughter outside the point, I'm on to where they're headed. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't crying through these words. Second seizure way longer and more violent than the first. Nothing showing on the test, so we're kinda reassured. But when you're trying to search for answers, then that silence is a curse. We were lying in a merge, steady streaming tears, try confiding in a nurse. Everybody got a story of the child and the hurt, telling us we'll be okay. This is why they come to work, see we're blessed. I really wish them the best. It's these visions in my head that still get me upset. They said when the sun's up they would move them and send a helicopter from the children's come to get them instead. But the weather's too aggressive, so they're sending a team of pediatric specialists to get them. But we couldn't both go, there's not enough room. So mommy sat up front, baby rolled with the crew. Daddy on the curb, tears fully consumed. Both eyes, then my eyes slowly rolled into view. I watched them take off, Aaron's parents arrived. Then I could never explain how much I cherished that ride, how much I love them both and the care they provide. So I just sat in the back, held Sierra and cried. Stared up the side at the desert, now there's nowhere to hide. That's the night life's innocence was buried alive. This for every first responder that was there in that time, to hold the wings of our angel and help carry him by. I got a text from my wife that they made it to Chalk, and he was pissed, trying to kick, losing patience with docs. Pulling at his IV, tried taking it off, yelling at the nurses that he hates at a stop. I checked in, flu season, only parents allowed. Gave my daughter a kiss and saw it tearing her house. She wants to go to her brother, not be left there in the crowd. Forever blessed that she had her grandparents around. We just carried him round, cause he was too hot to walk. Waiting on any doctor just to cruise by and talk. I never felt so uncertain, but I knew I'm in shock. Every hour looked the same when I was viewing the clock. We had to keep him awake all night for the test. Sleep depth is a trigger, results might turn out best. Nurse said if he ceases, bring him right to the desk. We're just praying like Jesus, this the life that he gets. Pulled that red wagon round the hospital halls. They came to hook up the wires and he just fought through it all. But then he gave in and we were watching him fall into the sleep that he needed until the doctor would call. We got a reading.
Your son is epileptic.
Never heard a phrase that's so bloody unexpected. Embrace my wife, try to find some comfort and acceptance. You're not different, baby boy. You're so lovely and you're precious.